Yo, what up, guys? Sammy Lee here from the Soul Brothers, and today I just got a dope shoe in. Well, not today, it was yesterday. I already played in these once, and thank you to Under Armour for sending these out. This is called the Anatomic Spawn Low, so I guess they're gonna make a high version or a mid version, and it is $110, I believe. Yes, $110. Which is a good budget price, and it uses Micro G. Right when I said I miss Micro G, they make a shoe that has Micro G, so that's dope. You know, Micro G was their super nice cushion that they used from, I think, their Clutch Fit Drive, and also their original Anatomic Spawn basketball shoe. And the reason why I am excited about these shoes is because I think it was one of their first like main basketball shoes that they were giving to like NBA players like Steph Curry and stuff. When they first started to go into the basketball shoe market, and that was the Anatomic Spawn, and it had like a lot of like weird panels on it with Fuse and Micro G. So I am excited to, you know, test these out. So let's get it started off with the traction. So you have a totally translucent outsole with some like black speckles, and it's more of like a wavy line pattern. Very interesting. And this is the craziest outsole pattern that I've ever seen in my life. Like, the rubber comes up so much and it's so deep and pliable that I've never seen anything like this. So I did play in it once and the traction was really good, but like rubber that's deep like this, I kind of don't like, because, you know, when I'm stepping, I can kind of feel like the rubber, you know, move a little bit because it's so long and deep, you know? Just a little minor gripe though. It doesn't really affect performance all too much, but it just reminds me of like the PG2 and how it felt. Like, just like from the rubber moving a little bit. But that's not a huge deal. The stop seems to be really good. Really quiet squeak though, not like too much squeaking, but stop is really good. Dust doesn't really seem to affect it because it's really widely spaced and it doesn't seem like it's trapping dust at all. I only played in these once, and there is fraying on the rubber. I don't know if you guys probably can't see because it's focused right here. And if I go like this, and it's out of focus, but there is a lot of fraying, especially in the forefoot area. And that's only from one day of playing. So I don't know if it's going to be the most durable rubber for playing outdoors, or even a durable rubber for indoor use. But traction seems to be really, really good, and I am very, very happy about that. So there's that. Moving on to the cushion. The cushion is a Micro G. It does feel a little bit different than the Clutch Fit Drives. When feeling it with your hand, you can feel the Clutch Fit Drive Micro G a little bit more, and it's a little bit softer. I feel like this is kind of a mix between like a carrier, and maybe they put it like a Micro G core and it's a little bit softer there. Or they just stiffen it up a little bit because they're, you know, the entire midsole in the heel is basically exposed. So they want to give you a little bit more stability in that way. But yeah, Micro G, there is a good amount of compression. It feels really soft. It's slightly bouncy. It feels a little bit different than the Clutch Fit Drives to me. Heel to toe transition seems to be smooth. There is a little bit of a curve up as well, so that feels nice. Impact protection seems like it's gonna be nice, but also really responsive, and court feel seems to be really good as well. And this type of cushion setup I really like, because I like to have a really responsive, you know, like a no bullshit type of cushion, but with good impact protection. That's what this shoe seems like it is. And also another really nice touch is the insole. I'm not sure what type of insole they use, but Under Armour really, you know, usually kills it with their insoles. It makes it very soft and feels pretty much like a memory foam type of material, and, you know, just the stepping comfort is greatly improved because of the insole. So yeah, overall cushion, very nice, and I'm very excited to, you know, break it in a little bit more and see how it performs then. But as of right now, it feels really good. All right, moving on to the materials. Materials, you have a foam back mesh in the toe area, and it's actually not that bad. It feels really soft, very pliable, and really thin, but seems pretty supportive. And also, that's a good thing, like, to have in the toe, you know. And Under Armour, I think, strategically place, you know, these synthetic panels because, you know, you really don't need any, you know, support or anything in the toe area right here. I like to keep that soft and, you know, make it very soft so that it doesn't feel like too restrictive. But they did add some synthetic overlays in the toe area and also in the, you know, lateral side and also on the medial side. And they put an additional layer of it's kind of like a milky white synthetic overlay over already the synthetic overlay. So they have multiple synthetic overlays in, I guess, the lateral side of the shoe, which is a nice touch because, like, they where it needs to be soft and stuff like that, they keep it soft, but where you need support, they put the support. And it says it's an exposed mesh, so yeah, it basically is. And it seems like there are little cuts throughout the foam, you know, with the foam back mesh, and breathability also is improved because of that. Yeah, so it says here, interwoven layers of TPU films and polyurethane coated mesh for multi-layer support in an anatomical design. Yep, so materials, they're actually very nice, you know, I'm not mad at it. It's not like the most premium feeling quality, you know, in hand and stuff like that, but on foot, and then, you know, just walking around it, it feels really soft, comfortable on foot. And I really like this tongue as well. It's pretty well padded. Moving on to the fit, I don't know, man. I guess they changed the last or something like that, but I went down half a size. I asked for a half a size down just to be safe. And half a size down seems like a perfect size, you know, fit for me lengthwise. So I would suggest going down half a size. It's really weird. Every single Curry, every single other shoe that I've tried before this year, I've been, you know, 7.5, but now, you know, their shoes seem to be running long. Width-wise, I would say it's, you know, on normal width, not too narrow, not too wide. So it's a really nice fit for me, not too snug. So, but overall fit, really nice. Super easy to put this shoe on, you know. The tongue does connect. It's kind of like a tech fit booty where, like, the tongue attaches to the middle of the shoe and there's an underlaying material that attaches to the tongue, and which improves fit. There is no Achilles pillow. There is a little bit of a baby lip though, and I didn't really seem to have any heel slippage. Support and lockdown seems like it's going to be really good, especially lateral support. You have the rubber coming up a lot here in the forefoot area, which, you know, kind of covers the forefoot lateral containment, and you have the Micro G midsole coming up a lot as well in the heel for lateral containment as well. And you also have an added internal TPU heel counter for extra support. One thing that I did notice is that this kind of reminds me of the Kobe 10, where, you know, while I was doing like a cross or a lateral movement, this kind of hurt my pinky toe. So that my pinky toe is kind of banging on it. It's not horrible like the Kobe 10 was, but I felt it a little bit and it did hurt, but I'm sure once I break it in, it's gonna be a lot better. All right, moving on to the weight. I just weighed these and it is 11.04 ounces. Super light, very minimal feeling shoe as well, like no bulk. And it seems like it's gonna be a very responsive shoe as well, you know, cause traction is really good, cushion is responsive, materials are very supportive, and fit seems to be good. Again, these are $110. If you guys want to cop, we'll leave a link in the description box. All right, moving on to the aesthetics. Aesthetics, I do like how these look. You know, they look pretty interesting in their own way, but on foot and just like kind of looking at it in person, it looks a lot better than, I guess, kind of in pictures. And so tell us what you guys think down in the comment section below, but I like these. It seems like my first impressions, you know, they're really nice, and I feel like it's only gonna get better once I keep playing in them. So yeah, there's that. But performance review will be coming soon. But that's it. That's the video. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next one. Peace.